Detroit, no matter how close the Blackhawks come to folding, they always have Patrick Kane. He's been quite the ace as this team struggles to stay in the playoff hunt. Kane saved the Hawks again Wednesday, this time with an overtime goal to finish the Red Wings 5-4 after his team blew a 3-goal lead in the third period. The Harrowing win jumped them ahead of Minnesota for the second wildcard spot, which they now share with the Avalanche. "We're winning games, and I think we still feel we can play better in here," Kane said. "But we're in a playoff spot right now, so let's be excited about that, knowing we've got to bring a little bit more the last 21 games, regardless of how they've done it. They've won 10 of 12 and they're finally here. They evened their record at 2-6-2-6-9 and they're locked with the Avalanche at 61 points. Colorado has a game in hand, but the Hawks can pull ahead when they meet Friday at the United Center. Patrick Kane celebrates his game winner in overtime. Getty Images. They hold this thrill loosely after a brutal performance that was barely enough to get by a bad Detroit team, but it has been an impressive climb. The Hawks were buried in December and still sat 10 points out of a playoff berth a month ago. "I'd rather be in than out," coach Jeremy Colliton said. "Still need to work on our game. Game isn't where it needs to be for us to compete in the playoffs, and we're going to have to play better to get the points we need coming down the stretch. We keep finding a way to do it, and that's a credit to the character we have in our group that they find ways to do it no matter what. That's nice, but they should never try to do it this way again. There's little to love about letting a 4-1 lead unravel over the final 16 minutes and allowing a gimme game against the lowly Red Wings to go to overtime." Detroit outshot the Hawks decisively, like most teams do, and tied it with 1:26 remaining in regulation after going empty net. There were isolated instances of impeccable defense, such as Slater Kogic thwarting Dylan Larkin's breakaway with 4 minutes left in the third and Eric Gustafson's takeaway to launch the attack in overtime. Gustafson rested the puck in the Hawks' end and fed Taves to start the rush. Taves was unable to force it in the net, but went behind the net and drew all three Red Wings with him. He kicked it out to Gustafson, who was eyeing Kane on the right side all along, and they connected on a machine-like one-timer for the win. "I saw Kane right on the back door and I was gonna pass it either way," said Gustafson, who bypassed a clean look of his own. "He's a good goal scorer, so just give it to him, always a good plan." Kane's goal was his second of the game and he ran the NHL season best point streak to 19. He has 16 goals and 26 assists during since starting it in early January. His 37 goals this season rank second in the league, and he is 9 shy of his career high. No Hawks played has been as big as Kane during their surge, but Alex DeBrincat as close. He had a hat trick Monday and followed up nicely with his 33rd goal late in the first period. The Hawks eked out ugly wins over the bottom two teams in the Eastern Conference to start the week. They survived the Senators 8-7, but it'll be harder to get through the weekend. The game Friday will be the first of three left against Colorado, then they host Dallas on Sunday. The Stars are in the first wild card position, 2 points ahead of the Hawks and Avalanche.